Hello everyone, my name is John Reed and I'm one of the engineers that works on Google Web Designer. In this video today I'm going to cover the high level of the user interface and how you can customize it for your own uses. I'm not going to go into any detail about any of the individual features. We have lots of other videos for those, so please check those out. We're going to start here at the opening screen for Google Web Designer. You can see there's lots of different ways you can get started. If you need help, you can find some help. You can create a new file. You can use a template. We have a wide variety of templates that you can explore and use for your different uses. We also have a recent file list here, which lets you open any recent files that you have. And you can open a file just using the file picker if you have one someplace else. I'm going to start off by creating a new file. I'm going to create an ad. I'm just going to give it a quick name here. And you can see there's lots of different files that I could create. I'm going to use these dimensions and keep the animation mode in advanced, so it'll start off in advanced mode in the timeline. And here you can see the user interface for the application. If you've used other design tools, this probably looks familiar to you. Over here on the left, we have our individual tools, and across the very top, we have the tool options bar. As you pick different tools, the options will change depending upon what tool you've chosen. We also have the drop-down menus across the top here, file, edit, view, window, and help. In the file menu, you can do the usual file things. Like, for example, you can open a recent file here. I'll open another overview file so that you can see that. And then you can see we have the individual files in a tab bar here. And then you have the edit, view, and window drop-downs. Control what panels are open here. You can see the responsive isn't open, so I'm going to add it. And so now the responsive is open. And if I want to, I can close it. And now it's gone. Also across the top here, we have the ability to switch between design view, which is this view, and code view, which lets you access your code directly. We also have the ability to pick different ways to preview, with different browsers to preview your work in, and different ways to publish your work. Over here on the right-hand side, we have the individual panels that you'll be using to do your work. These panels can be arranged in any order, in any way you want. You can move them from one group to another, or even create their own separate group. And if you want, you can even move things from one side of the application to the other. And we also have the ability to be able to have floating panels now. So these don't even have to be docked, and they can be of any size. You can move these panels to left or right. The timeline can go from top to bottom. So you have the ability to move the timeline to the top or the bottom there. We also have the ability to save these setups so that when you've made these changes and you've gone ahead and exited the application, when you open the application again, the layout will be there, so you'll have your workspace saved the way you want it. We also have our pages menu here, which you can use to add different pages. We have the breadcrumb, so that when you use that to dig into the DOM structure, the breadcrumb will be here. We have the zoom control as well. In the timeline, we have the ability to switch back and forth between quick mode and pro mode, and to preview animations. That about takes care of it for the high-level overview of the application. As I said, we have lots of videos that cover in detail these features, so please check those out, and thanks for watching.